From break of day till tea time whistle, the bench or chopping board, from Irish sink to lathe or mixer, axe for function, some for form, in the kitchen, at the factory, hands with purpose model love, manifested in their product, relation, memory, fashion, soul. Measuring out the flow of ages, generations come and go. What remains is craft and history. Dotties lined up to unload. In our hearths and in our kiln sheds, hopes of man and woman rest. In honing skill and watching nature, we store up moles for pots uncast. Our work is tethered to a promise, better future, happy now. But in our hearts, it is apparent that for its own sake, work is joy. This is the starting point for it all. A factory nestled between the Peak District and the industrial towns of the Midlands, quietly making some of the most iconic tableware in the world. This is Denby Pottery. Here is the central nerve, the thread that ties it all together. Generations of craftsmen and women clocking on, clocking off, sharing skills, sharing laughs. Some of them started as apprentices. They'll retire with pride that they dedicated a lifetime to the mastery of a job. That spout on your cafetiere, a human finger did that. The handle, applied by hand. Who does it? These people, Denby Potters. The committed and the talented. Lovingly forming the unique Denby clay, shaping the way people from all walks of life sit down to tea or throw a dinner party. It begins with this salt-glazed cordial flask. But who is this man? Lord Grey, proposer of 1832's Reform Act. Take a look at his face. It can only have been modelled from life. Assimilating the influence of arts and crafts, Art Nouveau, Ruskin and Guinard, high art meets the endearingly trivial in the forms of the money box or the stylized owl, all executed in the cutting-edge glazes of the Empire Age. Forward to the calmly striking centerpiece, embodying a reassuringly everyday quality and durability. This is real design for real people. These lads, Marmadukes, 1 through 7, something of an anomaly. Albeit a happy one, a little mascot for Denby between world conflicts. And so to Denby's renaissance, the fertile period from the 50s to the late 70s. Experimental, bold, contemporary forms signposting the confidence of a new kind of designer. The towering names of Denby's design history, Glyn and Albert College, Tibor Reich, Jill Pemberton, all taking influence from their cultural climate and distilling it down into tableware that looks as fresh and forward-thinking now as it did when it was hailed in its day. Take a closer look at Chevron, prompted by Scandinavian designs redolent of the 60s. Meet its Russian-influenced cousin, Arabesque, a source of warmth at the height of the Cold War. Moving forward into recent history, Imperial Blue, a knowing reference to past forms and glazes but conceived for the modern household. Versatile, durable, beautiful, and building on this theme, Halo. Organic rounded forms, deep patination harnessing the action of chance in the glaze. And there you have it. A tiny history of the life and times of Denby, told through some of its products. And the future? Natural canvas. A contemporary dinner service designed for present-day life. The motif? An intentional sampling of the era-defining chevron pattern. International, but homely. Clean, but earthy. The perfect medium for new-fashioned entertaining. Form, without formality. The logical extension of the Denby ethos.